Good morning everyone. Today we will start the second chapter of USST, that is our country and its neighbors. इस चैप्टर में हम हमारी कंट्री इंडिया और उसके पड़ोसी कंट्रीज के बारे में जानेंगे. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द चैप्टर. इंडिया इज लोकेटेड इन द सदर्न पार्ट ऑफ द कॉन्टिनेंट ऑफ एशिया. स्टूडेंट्स, यू हैव रेड इन क्लास थर्ड दैट द वर्ल्ड इज डिवाइडेड इनटू सेवन कॉन्टिनेंट्स, दैट इज नॉर्थ अमेरिका, साउथ अमेरिका, अफ्रीका, यूरोप, एशिया, ऑस्ट्रेलिया एंड अंटार्कटिका. एशिया इज द लार्जेस्ट कॉन्टिनेंट एंड आवर कंट्री इंडिया is located in the southern part of it. It is the seventh largest and the second most populated country in the world. According to area, its position is on the seventh, and according to population means jansankhya ya abadi ki baat kare to iski position second number pe hai. India, its land surface. India is a vast country. India is a very big country. From north to south, it stretches across about 3,200 kilometers, and from east to west, it stretches across about 3,000 kilometers. That is, the distance between the north and the south is 3,200 kilometers, and from east to west is 3,000 kilometers. It is surrounded by water on three sides, the Arabian Sea in the west, the Bay of Bengal in the east, and the Indian Ocean in the south. To its north are the high mountain ranges, that is the Himalayas. Our India is surrounded by three water bodies, that is the Arabian Sea in the west, the Indian Ocean in the south, and the Bay of Bengal in the east. And in the north, there are high mountain ranges of Himalayas, that is there are a series of mountains of Himalayas. India's landscape is very varied, that is India's land is of different types. It can be divided into six physical divisions: the northern mountains, the northern plains, the great Indian desert, the peninsular plateau, the coastal plains, and the islands. Look at the map on this page. The brown portion in the north denotes the northern mountains, that includes the Himalayas. Look here. The brown portion in the north is the northern region. The northern region of India is a mountainous region with snow-capped mountains. The world famous snowy mountain of Himalayas are also located here. The Himalayas form the northern border of India and are the highest mountain range in the world. Many rivers have their source in these mountains. The Himalayas act as natural boundary of India and are the highest mountain range in the world also. Many rivers start their origin from these mountains. Now the next is northern plains. What are plains? Plains are flat area with fertile land. The northern plains lie to the south of northern mountains. The northern plain lie to the south of northern mountain. Here the land is flat and fertile. The land in these area is very flat and fertile. That is why many food crops are grown here. Since the land is very fertile, so many crops are grown here. The next is the Great Indian Desert. The Great Indian Desert are also known as Thar Desert. The yellow portion in the west is the Great Indian Desert. It is also known as Thar Desert. The Thar Desert is the largest desert in India. It is in the northwestern part of India. This is a dry sandy area which receives very little rainfall. Desert is an area which is covered by sand. So this area is a dry sandy area and with very little rainfall. Yahan pe barish bahut hi kam hoti hai. The next is plateau region. Plateau is a land higher than the land around it. Thodi uchi jameen hoti hai. The plateau region is triangular in shape. This pink color, plateau region, it is triangular in shape. It lies to the south of northern plains and extends till Kanyakumari, the southernmost tip of peninsular India. It starts from south of northern plains and extends till Kanyakumari. It is broad in the north and narrow in the south. Now the next is coastline. Coastline is a flat area of land near the sea or ocean. It has a beautiful coast. India has a beautiful coastline on both its eastern and western sides. The coastal plain occupies the land between the Western Ghat and the Arabian Sea in the west, and the land between the Eastern Ghat and the Bay of Bengal in the east. As I said before, that the coastal area is the land near the sea or ocean. It extends from Western Ghat to the Arabian Sea in the west and Eastern Ghat to the Bay of Bengal in the east. Now the last is island. There are island chains on both sides of the Indian Peninsula. यहाँ पे दो वर्ड आते हैं, आइलैंड एंड पेनिनसुला. वॉट आर आइलैंड्स? आइलैंड्स इज अ पीस ऑफ लैंड दैट इज सराउंडेड विद वाटर ऑन ऑल साइड्स, जो चारों ओर से पानी से घिरे हुए रहते हैं. एंड नेक्स्ट इज पेनिनसुला, इट इज ऑल्सो अ पीस ऑफ लैंड दैट इज सराउंडेड विद वाटर ऑन थ्री साइड्स. द आइलैंड फाउंड इन द बे ऑफ बंगाल आर अंडमान एंड निकोबार आइलैंड्स, एंड दोज फाउंड इन द अरेबियन सी आर लक्षद्वीप आइलैंड. लुक हियर इन द मैप. The island found in Arabian Sea is Lakshadweep Island, and the island found in Bay of Bengal is Andaman and Nicobar Islands, the blue portion over here. Again, the island found in the Arabian Sea is Lakshadweep Island, and the islands found in the Bay of Bengal is Andaman and Nicobar Island. Now, the next is states and union territories. We know that India is a big country with a large population. There are more than a billion people who live in Indian villages, cities and towns. In order to run it efficiently and take better care of the people, our country is divided into smaller areas. These areas are called states and union territories. India has 28 states and 9 union territories, including the national capital territory of Delhi. Students, as we know that the population of our country is very high, और उसे सही तरीके से चलाने के लिए इंडिया को छोटे छोटे पार्ट्स जैसे कि स्टेट्स और यूनियन टेरिटरीज में बांटा गया है. इन टोटल हमारे कंट्री में 28 स्टेट्स और 9 यूनियन टेरिटरीज हैं. द कैपिटल ऑफ अ स्टेट इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टाउन और सिटी इन द स्टेट एज इट इज द सीट ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ दैट स्टेट. हर स्टेट में एक मेन सिटी होता है जो कि उसका कैपिटल कहलाता है. जैसे कि हमारे झारखंड का कैपिटल रांची है. न्यू दिल्ली इज़ द कैपिटल ऑफ आर कंट्री. हमारे कंट्री इंडिया का कैपिटल न्यू दिल्ली है. द ऑफिसेस ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया आर बेस्ड इन न्यू दिल्ली. हमारा जो गवर्नमेंट है, जो कि प्राइम मिनिस्टर, प्रेसिडेंट और भी अदर सेंट्रल मिनिस्टर्स हैं, उनके ऑफिस सारे न्यू दिल्ली में हैं. The Prime Minister, the President, the Prime Minister and the other ministers of the central government and officials live here. और जो Prime Minister है, President है and the other minister of the same central government, जो central government के अंदर जो ministers आते हैं वो सारे New Delhi में ही रहते हैं.